You put your hands together for the fabulous Debra Lawrence.
Hi.
Debra, viewers were not happy you were booted out of the jungle. They said Australia got it wrong. Are you surprised by all the support you have back home?
Yeah, I was. It's lovely to hear, but I mean, it's lovely because it means that lots of people have heard about my charity, Ovarian Cancer Australia, and the good work that they do, and they can keep donating, by the way. But yeah, it was heartwarming when I got out and finally had a shower and looked at the social media stuff. It was, yeah, really surprising and lovely, just lovely.
Debra, the trial food is disgusting. Well, let me rephrase that. All the food in there is disgusting. How'd you go with the pig's penis?
I knew somebody was going to throw an anus or a penis at some of us, so it happened to be me, and I happened to get both a pig's anus and a pig's penis. But look, the shredded cheese helped, and certainly if you're going to eat a pig's penis, it's very wise to have sprinkles on it. I'm not ever going to look at fairy bread ever again in my life.
One of the many things that you've done in camp to entertain people is have conversations, deep and meaningful, including with the wonderful Liz Ellis. And you discussed ageing wonderfully, gracefully, positively. Did you learn anything, or was it more of a, you know, you sharing that with everyone else?
Well, it was about me sharing it and also leading by example, because I feel pretty safe in my skin. But, yeah, and Liz is the same. Her hair is white. Of course, she naturally lets that go that way. But she's a force of nature, you know, a beautiful, highly intelligent, talented woman. And so I guess both of us want to reflect that back so that we see more women that look like me, so that women sitting on their sofas looking at the TV go, yeah, actually, it's OK. And I've already had a couple of people who have been inspired to just grow their hair out. So, yeah, power to the grey.
I love that you've done that, but how tricky has that been over the years and over the decades to hang on to that authenticity when people are putting all sorts of injections into their faces?
Yeah, oh, look, I was never interested because it just alters your face is, for me, I mean, I don't mind what other people want to do, but your face is your work. And, there's hundreds, I don't know how many, muscles in the human face. So there's tiny expressions that you rely on all your muscles for. And a close-up on a movie, people need to see that. They need to see what you're thinking, and that's reflected in the expressions on your face. Not the big ones, but the tiny expressions. And so you need all of your facial muscles for that. So I was never interested in doing it. You know, I worried a bit about my neck, but, you know, hey, look, that's what it is. So I just think we need to start a big movement of having grey-haired, wrinkled women reflecting the women in the audience back to themselves. I think it's really important.
Peter Helly is obviously in there, our old mate from the desk, and his charity is Legacy. I'd like to urge everyone to vote for Pete. It is Anzac Day tomorrow, and we'd love to see Pete go all the way. He's been absolutely brilliant in there, hasn't he?
Yeah. Oh, he kept us amused, like a couple of characters. He's created a new one, which I think he's going to take on the road. But also Strawny turned up, which was just the distraction and the humour kept us all laughing. He's lovely to be around. And, yeah, I'm a Legacy kid. So, yeah, I support his charity, please. I'd love to see him go all the way through. He's in there. He's lost weight. He's been inspired by the whole process. It was lovely just to have him there because he's so warm and lovely. So, yeah, the project's really delivered this year with the campaign. So I know, Steve, I have to take the opportunity to bow down to you, Steve, because I absolutely admired what you did in there. And also maybe the others, you know, Sam and Sam, would you like to go?
No, I mean, Steve goes on about it so much that it feels like I've already done it. So I can probably leave it out, I reckon.
No, but...
Well, who goes next? Stay tuned for I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here, right after us. Debra, thank you so much for your time.
Great, thank you. And this is my sign off for my family.